Hey, favorite kids, Mary here, and it makes me so happy that you're joining us online today. Welcome to Favorite Kids TV. Hey, before we begin, have you told your friends about how much fun we have here? Yes, no? Well, if you have friends that don't know about Favorite Kids Online, share this link because you'll never know how much they wish they could see this. Also, if you haven't yet, subscribe right now to our YouTube channel so that you don't miss any of the fun videos we're rolling out this week. Anyway, are you ready for today? We've got a great service prepared for you. So get ready for an amazing time here at Favorite Kids TV.
What is up, guys? My name is Lorenzo. I'm so glad you're here and ready to dive into some pretty cool stuff with you. I mean, 95% of all living things on the earth live below the surface of the water. So it's an endless world of things to discover. It's amazing how God created all the beautiful and exciting things we love about the ocean. And I'm so pumped that we are going to dive in to a few of those today. One way we can get all our fins in motion is to play a game. And you'll see a picture of a sea creature, but it's going to be zoomed in one article. So you'll have 10 seconds to guess what that sea creature is. Are you ready? Let's count down from three and say fins. Here we go. 3, 2, 1, fins. That was so much fun, guys. You know what? There are so many awesome things in the deep blue and summer, so far below the surface, and we may never get to actually see them. But you know what? That actually makes me think of what it's like to follow Jesus. Sometimes we can't even see the awesome things that following Jesus might be leading us into. We can trust Him and move forward, believing that He has a good plan for our lives. One of the many reasons I really love following Jesus is it's always an adventure. Following Jesus is the best decision you can make. So let me hear you say this after me for as loud as you can. Are you ready? Here we go. Share Jesus. One more time. Share Jesus. That is right, kids, and good job. Because this song that we are about to sing, it's all about who Jesus is and all of the awesome things He does for us. When we sing, we're gonna get to know Him a little bit better. So let's do that now. Stand up, stretch your legs, and let's sing for Jesus.
I'd rather slip walking on water. Spend my life wondering what if, Lord, if it's you, tell me to come. 'Cause you alone can tame the wildest wind. I know I can make it, 'cause it was your voice that I heard. So I'm stepping out, I'm stepping out on your word. This is how you walk on water. One foot in front of the other. Never gonna let you go under. Just put one foot in front of the other. Okay. I got a faith deeper than feelings. Cause I know a name is greater than this storm. I got a God who never ever fails me. He's close enough to catch me if I fall. I know I can make it. Cause it was your voice that I heard. So I'm stepping out. This is how you walk on water. One foot.
Come on, show it.
Never gonna let you go on. Just put one foot in front of you.
Cause this is how you walk. This is how you walk, how you walk on water.
One foot in front of you.
Never gonna let you go.
Never gonna let you go on.
No,
just put
no.
Cause
this is how you walk.
This is
how you walk, how you walk on water.
One foot in front of you.
I'm stepping out on your word. I'm stepping out on your word. I'm stepping out on your word. I'm stepping out on your word.
I'm stepping out, stepping out, stepping out. I'm stepping out, stepping out, stepping out.
Hey kids, as we continue to worship, come on, why don't you just set aside any distractions and let's just give him all the praise, all the worship, and let's just lift our hands and fix our eyes on him. So come on, let's worship.
We invite your presence in this place. Worthy of every song we could ever sing. Of all the praise we could ever bring, worthy of every breath we could ever live for you.
Come on, sing Jesus.
Jesus, the name above every other name. Jesus, the only one could ever say, worthy of every breath we could ever breathe for you.
Come on, let's sing holy.
Holy, there is no one like you. There is none beside you. Open up my eyes. Show me who you are and fill me with your heart and lead me in your love to those around me.
this together.
Worthy of every song we could ever sing. Worthy of all the praise we could ever bring. Worthy of every breath we could ever live for you.
Come on, sing his name, Jesus.
Jesus, the name above every other name. Jesus, the only one who could ever save. Worthy of every breath we could ever live for you. We sing the holy.
Why don't we just just take this moment to encounter His presence.
I trust in You, 'cause You are good, You are faithful, Father. I will put my trust in You, Lord. I will put my trust in You, God.
Come on, let's sing this together. Holy.
Some great singing, kids, and even dancing. I saw your feet, guys. You know what? My friend Arlene has something awesome for us today. Check this out.
Hey there, friends. Thanks for popping by. I have some fun things to share with you today. Well, actually, my friends have some things to share. Here, listen to this. What a sound, right? That was a blue whale, and for all we know, he was telling his mom he needs a snack. But even if we can't understand him, the other whales in his pod most definitely can. These unique sounds allow them to share with the other whales in their pod. Scientists believe that the singing we just heard could mean a couple of things. One, they could be migrating, which just means they're moving from one place to another. Or number two, that they're trying to find another whale in their pod. Even though we may not be able to learn that difference from one blue whale to another, the whales in the pod most certainly can. Every single pod has its own unique sound to communicate with one another, but it also helps them spot the outsiders. You might also hear clicking noises from time to time. These help the whales navigate their way through the deep blue sea. For a while, scientists thought that the whale sounds get louder over time. but sadly, they just found that there's just more pollution preventing the sound from traveling. So because the noise can't travel when you're close enough to hear it, get ready because it is loud. And whales aren't the only animals that share information with each other by making sounds. Another adorable sea creature that has a lot to say is my personal favorite, the dolphins. While dolphins also share important information by clicking, their singing sounds are super unique from the whales. Here, have a listen. What a playful noise similar to whales. Dolphins know if another dolphin is in their pod just by their chattering sound. They even establish patterns of chattering so that they can easily communicate with one another. Dolphins are also quick to protect others in their pod from danger. So when a dolphin senses something harmful, they make sure to share that information right away. When I think about the different ways that dolphins and whales share with one another, I can't help but think about what it's like to follow Jesus. These animals know how to get a message to one another and share the important information that keeps them safe. In a similar way, following Jesus was the very best decision I have ever made. He saved my life, and I want to tell everyone. I can't help but think about all of the amazing things Jesus has done for me, and I want everyone to experience those things too. So I make it a point to share Jesus with others in any way that I can. And when you decide to follow Jesus, it's so important that you tell others all about it. Sharing Jesus is one of the best things that we can do for those we love.
Super cool and fascinating. Can you believe that there are creatures under the sea that have their own language? And I love how Arlene always finds a way to help us understand about how everything in creation points us back to Jesus. Hearing Arlene talk about sharing Jesus reminds me of a story in the Bible. Here, guys, check this out.
God's story. Peter preaches. So remember how part of God's story is about a guy named Peter who followed Jesus even though he messed up sometimes? Well, it goes like this. After Jesus died to rescue us, he came back to life. 40 days later, he rose into the sky, right up to heaven. Right before he left, he told his disciples, "The Holy Spirit will come upon you and give you power. Then you will tell everyone about me in Jerusalem, in all Judea, in Samaria, and everywhere in the world." After that, Peter and the others weren't sure what to do, so they waited together in Jerusalem. While they waited, a sound like wind came from heaven. They saw flames that looked like tongues land on their heads. They were filled with the Holy Spirit. Other people who followed Jesus were waiting in Jerusalem too. And when they heard the sound, they all crowded together, even though they spoke lots of different languages and couldn't talk to each other. But the Holy Spirit gave Peter and the disciples power. Now they could show people how to follow Jesus. See, the Holy Spirit helps us do things we can't do by ourselves. That day, the disciples spoke, and everybody understood them. That's like if someone said something in Latin or Swahili, and we understood it. Seems impossible, but that's what happened. So Peter stood up and told everybody how the Holy Spirit had come, and that we can all follow Jesus. He said, "Turn away from your sins and be baptized in the name of Jesus Christ. Then your sins will be forgiven. You will receive the gift of the Holy Spirit." By the way, that means that when we believe in Jesus, we get the gift of the Holy Spirit too. Anyway, Peter told huge crowds of people about Jesus that day, and more than 3,000 people chose to follow him. Jesus had given Peter a job, and with the help of the Holy Spirit, Peter would do that job for the rest of his life. And that's part of the story of Peter. So, in case you missed it, here's the quick version. Jesus died. He came back to life. He rose up to heaven. His followers had a job. They waited for the Holy Spirit. The Spirit came. Peter spoke. Everyone understood. People believed in Jesus. They got the Holy Spirit too. And that's a part of God's story.
Wow, super! Peter had spent so much of his time being friends with Jesus and learning from him. It was like he couldn't help but share the good news of that Jesus had done in his life. Okay, let's see if you remember some of the things we talked about today. We have a couple of questions, it's just not a quiz, so check this out.
What does the Holy Spirit help us do? A, things we can't do by ourselves. B, scuba dive. C, eat spicy foods. Or D, all of the above.
That is right. The Holy Spirit helps us to do things we can't do by ourselves alone. It may seem impossible to share Jesus with others, but with the help of God and the Holy Spirit, we can share the good news about how Jesus loves us so much, just like how Arlene wants us to do, and just like Peter did long ago. That's why Jesus promised to send the Holy Spirit to help us share Jesus with others. You guys, today's been so much fun, and I hope that you'll come back next week because we have a lot of things for you. But before you go, let's pray together. Jesus, you are awesome. We love you so much, and thank you for dying to rescue us and coming back to life. And thank you for sending your Holy Spirit to help us every day. Please help us to share you with others, and we want to get to know you more and more. Please show us how to follow you every day. In Jesus' name, amen.
Kids, did you enjoy that? I hope you had a great Favorite Kids experience. If you had fun, tell all your friends about it and share this channel with them. And don't forget to subscribe here so that you don't miss out on any of our videos. And always remember that you can dive in for all God has for you. Can't wait to see you again here on Favorite Kids TV.